Very good morning, children. So today, yesterday we had discussed about basics. We started basic science classes. So we studied about motion and its types. So next, today we will study about force. What is force? Different definitions we'll study. And in broader perspective, afterwards we'll go through one by one, like regular classes. So what is actually force? Force is push or pull of an object. When you push anything, if I push a dust from here to here, this becomes a pull. If I pull like this, push. Okay. So this very simple example. If I take a pen and keep here, this is a static object. When you push this, we are applying force on the body. So force is push or pull of an object. So actions like hitting a ball. When you hit a ball with a bat, you are applying force through the bat. And when opening and shutting at the door. When you open the door, you pull it. And when you close the door, you push it. So these are the actions which show the force is done there. So there is one more word called friction. Friction is opposing force between the surface of two contact of two bodies. When two bodies are in contact, when they slide or roll with each other, then the action is done. The force is up, the friction is done. In simple words, friction is opposing force. When you apply force in opposite direction, then that becomes a friction. So due to friction, we are able to walk on the ground. Means, when you walk from the surface also, there is a force. That opposing force is called friction. So after friction, we come to know what is actually pressure. So pressure is nothing. It is defined as a force acting on an area, particular area. Suppose, I am taking pen and writing here. I am applying pressure there, pressure. So with pressure, I am applying and writing. So that becomes a pressure. Means, so force applied on a particular area is called pressure. When you apply force on and right here, that becomes pressure. Means, pressure is defined as the force per unit area. The unit of pressure is Newton per second. Okay. Then there is one more word called atmospheric pressure. So this is the reason why we feel cold, hot, or sometimes humid climate, because of the atmospheric pressure. Means the pressure exerted by air is called atmospheric pressure. It is measured by an instrument called barometer. So this instrument helps to measure what is the atmospheric pressure in a particular area. So again, we have one more word called work. What is work? When you say work, means actually, if you sit simply on chair, that is not work. Okay. So work is said to be dull. If force acting on a body is able to move its through some distance. Suppose you are sitting on the chair and simply sitting, means it is not force. It is not work done. When you get up and move from one place to another place, okay. So there is force acting on you and you are able to work. And that is called force. So force is nothing, not force, work is force and displacement. Work is force with respect to displacement. Means suppose you apply force on a particular body, the body moves a particular distance. So that becomes work. So work is done only on a body if it is made to move, if it is undergoing displacement. Okay. Then what is energy? We will find what is energy. See, we can call energy. If you do, the capacity to do work is called energy. So in energy there are two types, one is kinetic energy, one is potential energy. In kinetic energy, the body is made to move If the body is moving, then it is said to have kinetic energy. And the body which is at the constant, for example, water tank filled. The filled water tank will indicate the potential energy, means energy is stored in the body. Okay. So the capacity to do work is called energy. So we have two types of energy. One is kinetic energy. So the energy possessed by a moving object. The energy possessed by any moving object. Moving object. Okay. So example is moving of a vehicle. Moving of a bike. Or flowing of river. Okay. Then one more is potential. Actually the meaning of potential is which is stored. Okay. Kinetic energy and potential. So the energy is stored in an object, body is called potential energy. Your example is stored water tank. So these are the two different types of energy. So in physics actually it is a very long subject. There are many multi interdisciplinary subjects are there. So for that we will stop here only, and afterwards we will continue the other classes. Then we will go to a subject called chemistry. Then initially you should know what is actually chemistry. I told already we are learning physics, chemistry and biology. Okay. So now we try to understand actually what is chemistry. Okay. So chemistry is a branch of science. Branch of science which deals with composition of matter. It is a simple definition which you can easily remember. Okay. Then in this we will try to find what are chemical changes and physical changes. Physical changes. The name itself indicates. Okay. The changes which occur in a physical object in the form of change in color, change in size, shape, change in size. Okay. The changes that occur due to changes in color, shape, size that are found physically. So these physically, these objects can be retained once again. We can get these back once again. Okay. These can be retained. For example, ice changing into water. So again, from this we can get it back. Again, water can be converted into ice. So such a change where physical change occur, color due to color, shape, size is called physical change. Then chemical change means what? Here the changes that occur due to changes in the chemical composition. The changes that occur due to the internal changes. And where new substance is formed. New substances are formed. For example, ripening of fruit. Okay, once the fruit ripens, again we'll not get it back. Ripening fruit. And burning of incense stick. So these will indicate the physical and chemical changes. Okay. Now we'll go to the basic. These are the simple. Then we go for what we will try to find what are atoms, what are elements, what are molecules, what are compounds.